The captain was sleeping when the accident happened. The captain was sleeping when the accident happened.
So what kind of bait do you use when you go fishing? So what kind of bait do you use when you go fishing?
There are about 13 crew members working on this ferry. There are about 13 crew members working on this ferry.
That's a lot of grime on the deck. That's a lot of grime on the deck. What's the right? What's the right?
We have to regain our speed if we are going to arrive at our berth on time. We have to regain our speed if we are going to arrive at our berth on time.
We need to buy a pair when we get into port. We need to buy a pair when we get into port.
Is it still hailing out there? Is it still hailing out there?
It's not that sample, you know. It's not that sample, you know.
The crew got stressed when they heard the alarm go off. The crew got stressed when they heard the alarm go off.
Let me give you an example of a recent pirate attack. The ship had just crossed the South China Sea and was negotiating a busy strait around midnight. So it's possible the pirates boarded the ship unseen from one of the small vessels nearby. Anyway, five men entered the bridge and threatened the master. They were all carrying knives, and they forced him to open the ship's safe. Well, the master had no choice, so the pirates were able to empty the safe and escape with $25,000 and some other valuables. Let me give you an example of a recent pirate attack. The ship had just crossed the South China Sea and was negotiating a busy strait around midnight. So it's possible the pirates boarded the ship unseen from one of the small vessels nearby. Anyway, five men entered the bridge and threatened the master. They were all carrying knives, and they forced him to open the ship's safe. Well, the master had no choice, so the pirates were able to empty the safe and escape with $25,000 and some other valuables.
A general cargo vessel was at anchor in the outer harbor waiting for further orders. The main engine was shut down, and the position of the vessel was checked and recorded every 30 minutes using radar and GPS. But that evening the weather started to worsen, and the wind increased to gale force. After a while, the master realized that the vessel was dragging her anchor. He tried several engine and rudder movements, but he couldn't stop the vessel, and she ran aground on a nearby beach.
So, have you finished yet? You seem to be doing a very thorough job.
Well, we've checked all the cabins, the storerooms and the cargo tanks, but we still have to check the medical stores.
Okay, I'll show you where they are. Please come this way. But I can assure you, you won't find any drugs on my vessel.
Okay, guys. Today we're going to work on the foredeck. First, you need to chip off the rust and prepare the surface properly before you start painting.
How many coats of paint does it need?
Probably 2. Oh, and remember to add some thinner. The paint is really thick. If you come with me, I'll give you the chipping equipment, the rollers, and 6 tins of paint to start with.
So, made any plans for your next home leave yet?
Well, not really. You know how it is. After a long spell away, all you want to do is put your feet up in your own house for a bit.
Oh, yes. But my wife always finds stuff for me to do while I'm at home. I don't get much peace.
Yeah, mine's the same. But I help with the family business, too. I like it. It's as if I'm working and thinking for myself and not just obeying orders.
Yes, I know what you mean. It's good to make your own decisions, isn't it?
Good morning, Port Plymouth Emergency Clinic. How can I help you?
Good morning. This is Chief Officer Sergei Orlov. We'll arrive in port at 1400 hours today. I need to make an emergency appointment for one of our crew members.
I see. What's the matter with him?
Well, he fell down some stairs earlier this morning, and he may have broken his left arm. He can't move it.
I see. Well, as it's an emergency, you don't need an appointment. Just come in as soon as you arrive in port. Remind him to bring his passport, and bring some to translate for him if necessary.
I was reading a report on mooring operations. They cause a lot of accidents. Do you know when most of them occur?
Mooring, bad weather conditions?
Well, a few are due to the weather.
Okay, so I guess most have to be due to equipment failure?
Actually, that's the least common cause. Apparently, the majority of mooring accidents are due to poor handling of ropes or wires.
Yes, that makes sense.
Have you spoken to the new third engineer yet?
Yes, he seems like a good guy.
Really? I was starting to think he might be depressed or have marriage problems or something.
Why do you think that?
When I tried to speak to him yesterday, he just reacted like he was deaf or something and completely ignored me.
Well, if you were speaking to him too loudly or even shouting at him, he would feel humiliated in public. Men from that culture don't like being spoken to like that.
Have you spoken to the new third engineer yet?
Yes, he seems like a good guy.
Really? I was starting to think he might be depressed or have marriage problems or something.
Why do you think that?
When I tried to speak to him yesterday, he just reacted like he was deaf or something and completely ignored me.
Well, if you were speaking to him too loudly or even shouting at him, he would feel humiliated in public.
Hello? Hello, Captain. This is Mike from OST Agency speaking.
Hi, Mike. Any news about where I'll join my ship?
Yes, you're going to join the vessel in the USA. However, your American visa expired last year. Please bring us your passport, seaman's book, and two photos taken within.
Crew and Company, Olga speaking.
Hi, this is Master Avtandil calling from NV Marigold. Could I speak to the crew manager, please?
Could you hold on one moment, please?
Well, that's a good job done. What's the next lot?
There are 750 bales of cotton to load. We have to finish before 1300 hours because your ship is moving to another pier. The tug has already been ordered.
I didn't know that. Which pier are we going to?
Oh, not far. It's just on the other side of the river.
Well, that's a good job done. What's the next lot?
There are 750 bales of cotton to load. We have to finish before 1300 hours because your ship is moving to another pier. The tug has already been ordered.
I didn't know that. Which pier are we going to?
Oh, not far. It's just on the other side of the river.
Let's check what you've done. Have you checked all the scuppers yet?
Yes. They've already been plugged.
Great. What about the oil spill removal kit?
Yes, it's in position.
Okay. But I don't see the oil absorbent. Where is it? Have it brought immediately. You know we can't start bunkering without it. What else? The main engine is on standby now. The moorings are secured, the tanks have been sounded, and the fire hoses are positioned. Now we just have to wait until they bring the oil absorbent, and we can start bunkering.
Before you sign the contract, please can you read the terms and conditions carefully? And if you have any questions, just ask me.
I can't see anything here about overtime.
It's in the fifth paragraph here. It says the company will pay overtime for ratings.
What about the seniority bonus?
Let me see. According to the company rules, the seniority bonus is only...
This permit hasn't been completed properly. It looks like you did it quickly to me. I know you've got a lot of work.
Have you spoken to the new third engineer yet?
Yes.
This permit hasn't been completed properly. It looks like you did it quickly to me. I know you've got a lot of work to do, but you can't afford to take these kind of risks. You need to keep your mind on the job.
No, I took time to do it, and it's nothing to do with my workload. I can manage that. I'm sorry, but I was up all night with toothache, so I'm really tired.
In that case, you're in no fit state to be doing the job. You're more likely to make mistakes or have an accident.
Hello. I'd like to apply for a junior deck officer's position with your company.
Okay. What grade is your certificate and where did you study?
I graduated from the Maritime College last year and I have a junior watchkeeper's certificate.